Well, let me say this. So does that mean that if you get a cough and from then you know that your medicine has some alcohol in it, should you not take it? Well, I think that we're looking, I've never really seen a lot of people, Brother Justin, want to get drunk off of a nightclub. Just typically as the thing people do. Now, if you have a problem with that, probably best to stay away from nightclub. Now, you may say, well, Brother, why do you say that? Because we find that it was even given on the cross. They would give that to individuals as a sedative. And so, I think that we have to find the boundaries of medicine and the boundaries of what would be intoxication versus what is the purpose behind this. Understanding that God doesn't want us to live our life not being mentally alert. What does he tell us to do? He says, be sober, be vigilant for your adversary. You know, the devil, he's a roaring lion and he's roaming to and fro, seeking whom he may devour. If we are not clear in our minds to make judgment and in our thinking, it is an inlet for the devil to get into our life. The Word of God says, be sober. I see the time. I have some other things I could share, but I hope that I've shared enough tonight that it's a basis for you to be able to utilize in your life, because it does come up in talking. I work a job. It comes up a lot. People ask me. So we need to know a reason why. Don't be running books and say, well, our church doesn't believe in that. Well, that doesn't help someone else who doesn't come to our church. And where does our church get the foundation for this at? So understanding the principles from God's Word. I want to give you opportunity to share tonight. Does anyone else want to share anything?
Well, I had a friend. Her husband. He was an athlete.
Okay.
This girl loved it.
Okay.
And he went to Mexico to see her in the sun. And they played that much that she had to come care of him. And he became a faithful. He had to take care of him for about 10 years before he died.
Wow. I mean, we have to know that accidents occur, and we do know, medically speaking, alcohol consumption. I mean, there's some folks that they have to have it. Some folks may say, well, a functioning alcoholic, your body still isn't functioning the way that God has intended it to function. Not when your liver is hardened with cirrhosis. Not when you're becoming jaundiced and your body is not filtering. You know, there are people that will go to a premature death because of the disease that they suffer with. I just take that back to the disease that they suffer with. And the fact of drinking, the disease that they suffer with in their kidney or their liver from drinking. Drinking is not a disease.
What's that?
Oh, yeah. Hepatitis, cirrhosis.
Galatians 5:19 to 21 lists the works of the flesh, and right in there, drunkenness is mentioned as not inheriting the kingdom of God. It's right there.
Amen. Amen. Someone else, thoughts? Helpful tonight? Hopefully helpful in some ways for you to think about. I want us to be educated. I want us to know the Word of God well enough that we can show people from the Word. Now I know, let me also just say this in closing. I know that when we look at the Word of God, wine, strong drink, it covers everything from wine coolers to vodka. So even though we may have different labels for it, it still falls under the same category. And when you look at it, you know, from sedative standpoint, if you're taking some type of treatment for sick, all that's controlled. Thank God for control of opiates, all that. So I think it's understanding and drawing the line. Anyone else tonight? Stuart, Prince Stuart.
But in Ephesians 4, verse 30, it says, and grieve not the Holy Spirit of God, providing your seal and the day of redemption. And when we're born again, come by his name. There's a work that he does in our heart, but what grieves him, grieves us too. And I believe the closer we are to him, the more we won't want to be happy, that we know is this pleasing to him. Nothing that would break that seal under the day of redemption. But it would be so frightening. You know, Sister Holly started with the song, This Is the Day. And I've been thinking so much about this. We're closing out. Building our portfolio for school, and every day is just laser focused. We've got to get that done first. And every day has such a purpose to it. And if we, you know, if we put things off until tomorrow, I think, you know, I know I need to get this right with God, but I've got until tomorrow. We might not have that. And an uncle that I didn't know very well when I was very young, and he was one who was a lawyer. And my father had shared the Lord with him many, many times. And Uncle Gordon was never sober enough to really pay that much attention. Mm-hmm. He would say, I'll get right with God one of these days. But I've got time. When he ended up in the hospital, got my endometriosis. And he lived up in Minnesota. We were in West Virginia. And the Lord just laid it out on Daddy's heart that it was time to make another family trip, and specifically to go to the hospital and see him. And Rebecca and I were both at this age, so we couldn't go in yet to stay up in the waiting room. But remember, we prayed with Mama. He would open Uncle Gordon's heart that he would want to get right with God. And for the first time in a long time, he was sober enough that he understood. And my dad said, he just started to weep and to cry. And he said, I do want to give my heart to God. I'm so sick of the way I've been living. And he was probably in his 50s at that time. Not so terribly old, but very age. Living a life of morality. And the doctors had given him no hope. He was that far gone. And the Lord healed him, and he lived for 2.5 more years.
Praise
and
God.
All of his family and friends said he knew what he saved him. He didn't drink anymore, and he kicked his girlfriend out.
Wow.
And his life was radically changed. But, you know, like different ones were saying, where immorality comes in, it's like there's no care, no concern. And of course, he seems so and I believe the devil kept him that way for so long. And God, in his mercy, sobered him up long enough, put him in the hospital, and sent my dad there with a message that he finally gets.
Amen. Praise God.
Especially music, where you're not a good old boy unless you're that, you know, if you're gonna be cool, we're gonna do this. And, but this goes back again to choosing your friends carefully and who you're hanging out with. There's a lot to say about that. Something simple like that. Choosing your friends carefully. Because they will lead you on the paths. If you're weak in that area, guess where you're gonna go? You're gonna go with your buddies, you know? You're gonna do what you're doing.
And that's good, but Anna had a friend who did the unthinkable, didn't he? And I think that's what, even as parents, you know, being wise with, you know, who you're children. But yes, hopefully a foundation for the Word of God. That God is not a fool of the lifestyle of church. Anyone else tonight?
Family with that Abigail, her husband, and she went to jail. With all that there, she came back home, her husband was drunk, and having a party and that. Not long after that, the Lord took it down.
Yes, sir. Very quickly. Amen. It's time to let you go. Let's stand tonight. Take this fuel with you. Amen. Take the knowledge with you. Be able to, from the Word of God, share with others. Do it in grace and love. You know, people have been fed a lot of things from the Word of God that it's okay. But you take the Word of God and you share it. And in love, show them the truth of God's Word because they need it. Bo Justin, close us in prayer.
Gracious Heavenly Father, we give you all praise and glory for everything you've done for us and shall continue. Lord, we thank that your God's arranged and kind that is not like you, Lord. And I pray that you send angels around about us as we travel home or anything. That's on Sunday, Lord. May everything we say and do be pleasing in your sight. And ask all these things.